to a stunt rehearsal.
I'm about to jump from this little green cross down here to the second floor.
Morbius is a bit more a monster movie. This is a person who goes through a true personal transformation. And for that, I needed an expert.
I met with Daniel Espinosa, the director, and Lucas Foster, and we showed them our work.
We're super lucky to have him. He was nominated for an Academy Award. He is working with digital domain for a large part of our visual effects to create the vampires and the various different transitions of the characters and the environments that we're living in. Fantastic.
Matthew Butler is a brilliant visual effects supervisor. That's what I needed.
It's always a tall order to do something new in this industry. But I haven't done anything quite like this. What we're going to have to do is shake this one up and have it go up and down. But we jumped straight in and we jumped in at the deep end to create this monster. There's a desire to have Jared be Jared in a lot of this movie, yet he needs to be this living vampire.
Time to go.
So he can bloom from his humanoid version into this vampiric version, and it's typically done through anger.
I seek it out!
You know, it needs to look and feel and smell like that person, right? So Matt Smith needs to come through in his vampiric form. Jared Leto needs to come through in his vampiric form. And yet, we need to make this potentially horrific at times character.
I needed somebody who could portray the inner struggles that Morbius has from an exterior point of view.
Okay, so I'm part bad. Let's see what we can really do.
And one of the things Daniel was particularly interested in doing was visualizing some of Morbius's special powers. And one of which is his ability to visualize wind vectors and to echolocate like a bat would. But how do you visualize that?
I think they did a great job with the ability to kind of see using your sense of hearing. And it's fun to explore in a performance aspect, like how do you translate that?
If you want to be really pedantic about it, there's nothing to see. But obviously, you know, film is a visual medium. And what's nice about that is it gives us the excuse to do something that's really kind of visually sexy.
It's always interesting because as a comic book guy, we always contemplate how you would do when somebody discovers their fundamental elements, their powers.
My previous background was in aerospace, and since I focus on computational fluid dynamics and visualizing the flow of fluids, that particularly appealed to me because it's something I could see a way to visualize that in a sort of cool and not just gratuitous fashion. Like with most visual effects, there's never a single answer to anything. We try and use the right tool for the job, and each job is slightly different, so we're going to let them perform on stage now.
3, 2, 1, go!
But then recapture their performance with a marked up array of dots on their face and stereo helmet cameras on them that can capture all those minute details. And they're gonna have to come back and perform some things yet again. And then we're gonna render that and put that back into the shots.
Action!
Milo!
Got me.
They run around the tunnel, defying gravity, upside down. Then we bend around, they're over here, and they grapple on that lie. I don't think it's gonna get any better than that, yeah. And then they leap down the escalators. We're gonna motion capture their action. Yeah, I hope it works.
Yes! That's really good.
Yeah, that's great.
It takes you to places that you feel like you really haven't been before.
I hope that it's something that the audience finds visually stimulating.